will be done by BosHos, who is, as far as I am informed, the top runner, or one of the top runners, for that category of difficulty. So just wanted to clear that up in case anyone had any questions. Just a quick reminder of who we are and what we are doing. We are Speed Demos Archive and SRL. This is Summer Games Done Quick 2014. If you wish to tweet about this event, we would appreciate it greatly if you tweeted with the hashtag SGDQ2014 tag. All donations during this marathon are going directly to Doctors Without Borders. Doctors Without Borders is a international medical humanitarian organization created by doctors and journalists in France in 1971. Today, Doctors Without Borders provides independent, impartial assistance in more than 60 countries to people whose survival is threatened by violence, neglect, or catastrophe. Just to give some quick shout-outs to the folks who have been helping us during this event, Avermedia has graciously donated lunch for the attendees Monday through Friday this week. And they are also selling capture cards with a promo at bit.ly/SGDQ promo. If you are curious about how the ads and subscribers for this channel are working out, quick reminder that all of the ad money during this stream will help us make future marathons possible, providing equipment and funds to improve the quality of the stream and make things better. Subscriptions will all be donated to Doctors Without Borders, though, so all of the sub money for the entire marathon is going directly to Doctors Without Borders. Thank you for the $50 donation, Origami Zergling. I'm not sure how this works, but $50 towards Icebreaker. Also tell Cosmo that his ZZT run was the funniest thing I've seen all week. Thank you for your $20 donation, Troopa Koopa. Well, I'm up this late already. Now I need to see this ninja challenge. Keep up the great work, everyone. Oh, wait, ninja funded? This is going to trials then. Thank you for the $20 donation, T-Rex. Hey guys, T-Rex here. This is the second time watching. Really enjoying the event. Keep the good work and good luck to all the runners. Thank you for the $10 donation, One Mad Hat. Going to donate to Doctors Without Borders and not speedrun that trauma center game? Oh well, great job and great cause. That is a strong point.
I guess an hour 30,
not having trauma center is indeed an efficiency. Perhaps we can work on that for future GDQs.
Not so good. With the ninja track after, his goal is about 10 minutes on that.
What? Oh, where did they take that controller?
World record,
the guy who grabbed it.
58 something by Blaze.
The guy just grabbed his. He's pretty picky about having his own. Yeah, if you want to use mine or this one.
For those of you in chat who are curious, the ZZT run was earlier. So, remember, if there is any run
who took his controller
during the marathon that you were very curious about or just to watch again, there are multiple links being done in the chat.
Someone snagged his.
The speedrun social button
in the back, like someone was moving and organizing
the clip. Do you want
as well as the SDA official speedrun.
So, Merry Christmas.
Whoever grabbed
YouTube
that
page,
is probably going to at least need to give it back to him eventually.
Sometime after the event, high quality versions of all the videos as well.
Here, just pop it in there. You just want to plug it in the front.
Thank you for the $35 donation.
Are we able to slide the couch
love
a bit?
To all the SGDQ runners.
It. Just move it.
Shout out to Roman on the mic. Good luck.
Are we allowed to slide the couch a bit?
Runs.
we should be able to get you
on
camera.
Okay.
We should be able to get
you on camera. So we're good where we are?
Fine.
All right.
Yes, it's turned on, yes.
Thank you for the $10 donation. Dementu-Z, first time watching you folks live. Great people, games, runs, and cause. This goes towards the Inferno 4 Ninja Challenge.
Get this is a controller because you're insane.
Can we have some hype for the Ninja Challenge? Yeah. Perhaps a little bit of hype, everyone. Or not.
They can't really hear you.
We can't hear me? That's terrible. Can we get some hype for the Ninja Challenge? A little bit of hype? Or, yeah, yes. There we go. It took a little bit, but we got the hype. We got there. I'm extremely excited about this run. I don't know how everyone else is feeling, but I've played this game and cannot wait to see how it turns out.
They said they wanted to.
Chat, you did a great job hyping. I'm super proud of you. Oh my gosh. Chat, you are incredibly hyped.
What are they?
While we're waiting to kind of get started here, can we get a roll call for everybody?
Roll call. I am the Boss Hoss.
I am the Blaze. I speedrun Trials Fusion, Trials Evolution Gold Edition, Trials HD, and
so basically every Trials
game. I'm Zimbabwe, yeah. I speedrun Portal.
I'm Rachel, I speedrun Octodad, Valley of Sketch.
I'm Jeff.
I didn't say that.
Yeah. It is. It was on 100%. Not plugged in right now.
Thank you for the $20 donation, Timo. As a doctor, I can't thank you enough for your work, guys. Keep it up. This event is unique, and I'm happy to see it every year. Greetings from Germany.
Yeah, we've been on camera since we started setting up.
Quick reminder that we do not only have an English stream here, we also have a French restream that is being hosted in a location that I am currently unsure of, as we do not have it listed, but I am quite positive that one of the wonderful mods in chat will link the French restream shortly.
It's at 100%.
Thank you, Cassicus, for your $35 donation. Thanks for keeping me company during the late hours monitoring pipelines for work. Keep up the excellent play.
Go down here. Volume, yeah. Yeah, and the computer is muted.
Sick.
All right. Okay. All right.
Yeah. Get the mouse off screen. Oh, it's off. You're good.
Everyone's having trouble.
Take this thing.
Bend that closer.
Just so you guys know in the chat, we are working on getting the mic situation sorted out. We definitely want you to be able to hear the runner. That is of a high level of importance to us.
Say something.
Okay. Are we ready to go?
All right. Hang on. Talk to me a little bit about yourself, buddy.
And we're starting.
Fantastic.
Start time.
Are we...
Timer?
One second. And
they're not ready.
Testing. Exit. Press escape.
It shouldn't be that, you just commute with it.
Someone just chatted.
It may not be.
You might have to close trials and start it again.
A different device.
All right, as we are working out these slight problems here, we're going to go through a couple more donations. Thank you for the $5 donation, Oregon Zergling. I think I figured it out. Here's $5 for the sexiest announcer voice, announcer's choice. All right, well, all donations that I'm receiving will be going to the Metroid 1% race, which is very difficult and extremely exciting. I can't wait to see that. Thank you for the $50 donation, Ionesesco. Hey, everybody at SGDQ. Oh, yeah, that is loud, right? That is loud. That is some sound. That is some sound. We apologize to everyone wearing headphones. I am currently wearing headphones.
Now we get to hear the menu music.
And am deaf. Hey, everybody, to at SGDQ. Good luck on the runs.
Yeah, dude, there's lots of glowing in trials.
$50 split between Rachel and Jeff's choice.
Keep it up.
Yeah, this is the future.
If any part of the Trials Fusion runs gets world record, I'll donate another 50. So if any part, I'm assuming if there's an IL world record or if there's any kind of world record during this run, there will be another $50.
Nice.
I'm not sure if that...
Before you get started, wait for them to give them a countdown before you start.
Yeah, he's just checking settings.
Okay, so we are ready.
All right.
3, 2, 1, go.
I already got a friend request. So the start of this game is basically to unlock any bike, you have to do a training program, and this is training program 1, and you're going to unlock the baggy, which is the worst and slowest bike in the game. But with the PC, we're doing 100% run, so we actually delete the save files and start from absolutely nothing. So it's just a required part of the game. It takes time, but so the goal of this speedrun is basically going to be to unlock the bikes as fast as humanly possible. So he's going to be skipping around a lot, getting the fastest gold medals, because he has to get a gold medal on every single track, including skill games and FMX. So right after this, he's going to unlock the baggy and be able to enter the first event. In choosing these tracks, there are 5 single-player tracks and 1 skill game in the first section, and he's picking the ones with the lowest possible times because his bike is the slowest as of right now. But as he progresses through the game, he'll unlock better and faster bikes, so the speedruns will become quicker. And in these first tracks, in order for him to get gold, he's not able to fault and still maintain a good time, which is actually quite difficult with the baggy. It's not the easiest thing in the world to do. So playing it a little bit safe while still going fast is pretty necessary in these runs. So you're not going to see any world records like that $50 incentive in the at least in the first half. So
so we'll have to watch out for that later.
So he's choosing observatory because there's a part in this track that you'll see in a second that basically launches you across almost half of the whole entire track. So it's doesn't really matter using a faster bike for this part. And it's this part right here. There's some pretty awesome physics objects in this game, so. It's always fun to see. So right after this track, he's gonna go directly into the skill game, Balancing Act, which is the third fastest possible route to get a gold medal. He has to reach 200 meters. There's no leaning involved whatsoever. So it's purely a throttle control game, and he's gonna be using the baggy. So the next bike he's gonna lock is actually easier to use in the skill game, but this is necessary because it's quicker. So his goal is to stop as close as possible to 200 meters and then start the next event, which will unlock the Roach, which is a much faster and better bike. So yeah, he's not leaning. This is right there, he got it. Good job. So now the Roach is unlocked and he's gonna be moving right into the next section, which things are gonna start picking up a little bit. It's gonna be a little bit more fun. We're gonna need to see some time savers and some more intense stuff, but he has to complete the second training mode to unlock the next bike.
Welcome to the Samsara Industries training program, level 2.
So these are the training programs of Trials Fusion, and each one has checkpoints that you have to get in between. Now, usually you have to wait at each checkpoint, but because you can just literally press B and it skips the animation sequence of that checkpoint. You can also skip this checkpoint, which I am going to attempt to do here. I went a little bit too far, but it's okay. It's only about a second lost. And again, pressing B skips the animation sequence, and that is the end of the first training sequence.
So the bike he just unlocked is the Roach, and in all the tracks where There's big, long sequences. This is the fastest bike in the game, but it has a slower acceleration and basically lower agility. So in tracks like Turbine Terror, which he's gonna go back to eventually, it's a long, coasty, slow track, so he's gonna be using this bike. And still in in doing these tracks, he's still not allowed to fault to get the gold medal. But right now, he's easily on pace for a platinum time, but platinums aren't unlocked, so.
I hope I'm not alone in thinking that the shouts the Trials rider makes are the best part of this game.
Yeah, pretty awesome.
For the folks who are very new to the game, would you mind maybe explaining a little bit about the speed mechanics of it, so what you can do to make it faster or slower besides simply just the bike choice?
Besides just bike choice?
Yeah.
So basically the game is literally leaning left to right, and then you have left trigger and right trigger with gas and brakes. And so in this game, there's things called time savers, like I'll point out when he does one. And it's really, you want to keep traction almost 100% of the time. So up here, he grabs traction on that pipe right there as fast as humanly possible. So he slams his back tire down. But on this part right here, it's going to be faster to stop and explode up that, which is, that's a time saver right there. So finding little intricacies and little small details in this game is the key to doing it as fast as possible. It's really, a lot of it's holding gas and going pedal to the metal, but it's a little bit more detailed and like finesse game, and for someone who's brand new to the game, highly suggest it. If you like speedrunning in general, every track, the whole point of the game is to speedrun the track and get the fastest time. So it's a speedrunning game in a speedrun, which is pretty cool, just like another racing game. But yeah, it's basically you want to keep it, like just traction is a big thing in this game, which can be difficult to do. We'll see in the extreme tracks later on that there's some really steep parts, some climbs, and some parts where you have to like bounce. It's gonna get a lot more difficult. This is still really beginner stuff, but like doing that flip, he's gonna grab traction on his back tire and be able to push himself down faster. So a lot of small things like that.
And to add more to that, specifically in Trials, the back wheel is where all of the power comes from. So that's the wheel you really need on the ground 100% of the time.
Yeah, absolutely. And then with Trials Fusion, they actually released a Panda track, a Panda, which is a quad bike, and that's four-wheel drive. So the physics of that are a little bit different, and Blaze is going to explain that in a little bit when he gets to the Panda tracks. Another cool thing in Fusion, which is different from Evolution and HD, they released challenges, in three challenges in every single track, which are miscellaneous. It's going to be like, do 15 front flips, do tricks during the track, then there's ones where it makes your rider invisible, and we're going to see some of those later on that are pretty fun if we reach a donation incentive, so get donating.
Thank you for the $10 donation, Mars 2. Hey Blaze, it's Mars Z. Sorry I couldn't make it this year. Good luck on your run, and as always, it's a pleasure to watch you run this game.
So he just hit that section really, really clean. It's really smooth. He kept the traction on the back wheel and launched forward if you saw him do a little wheelie, which is a small detail that a lot of people miss when they're learning this game.
Thank you, Sevig, for your $50 donation. Shoutouts to Blaze and the other guys. Sub our hype. No controller Chocorino, please.
So this track right here is called Fusion Factory, and it has a lot of physics-based objects in it. This is probably the most difficult track in the earlier runs as far as not faulting. There's a lot of spots that he's probably going to do perfectly amazing, but they're really easy to fault at. And if he does, he's going to start over because it's a fairly long track. But as we see, he's destroying it right now, so.
And I would like to point out, if you've never played this game before, it is a lot tougher than he is making it look.
Yeah, this is a pretty fun track. He did really well. It was a pretty solid time. This is one of the skill games that can actually give a little bit of trouble. It's you have to time when you launch off, and you have to hit, what is it, 150 meters to get gold?
115 is gold. I was going to say Fusion Factory is one of the most annoying tracks in the game. But that went smooth.
Yeah, that was really good.
Come on, 115. Yes.
Nice. Good job, solid. First try.
Yeah, that can slow down a run quite a bit if you don't get that the first couple tries. So this is the first section of mediums. This training course actually doesn't unlock a bike, which is kind of odd, but I guess you're learning, it teaches you more difficult techniques. So watch this, and he's gonna do it as fast as possible and skip some checkpoints if possible.
So again, as before with the first training program, you cannot skip the first animation. So the opening gate opens, and every, just as before, we can skip all these checkpoints by pressing B. I'm gonna try and get under this. Pop this over.
Only one fault so far.
Faults do not matter on training programs, which is.
Yeah, can we really count that one?
No, that's training program fault. That's all good.
Yeah, fault's a fault.
So he's still in the point where to get a gold medal, he's not allowed to fault yet, which this track is one of the coastier tracks. A subtlety that you might not notice because you're not seeing his controllers and fingers, on some of the really big downhill parts, he's actually going to let go of gas. And in this game, you can go faster than the bike allows you by holding gas, by letting go and just letting it coast down really steep parts, which you're going to see in a second.
Thank you for the $20 donation. This ape, Blaze for President, Owl Hype. And thank you for the $15 donation, Oso Guinea Pig. Always great to see Blaze, the Owl JP, up at the plate. Owl Hype and no Owl Choke.
So you guys want the background story to why everyone's calling him an owl?
I'd be very interested in that,
yeah.
Yes.
So when he streams, when you're playing more difficult tracks and trials, like your head naturally tilts when you're going up really steep incline. So he'll be on stream and his camera will be there and you'll see his head and it'll just start tilting sideways and going farther and farther, and then kind of caught on, and now he's the Owl Blaze.
The harder the difficulty, the more it tends to happen, which is kind of a funny thing.
So this is actually the first track where he can get a fault and still get a gold medal. So the run essentially, he's still going as fast as possible, but it's not a big of a deal if he faults. He's not gonna have to restart the run, so.
The City Squirrel Conservation Program has successfully resulted in a total wipeout of the acorn population.
Right there, that's called a tire slide. That's wheeling up a ramp and getting your front nose over it, which is fairly difficult, and it lets you launch your bike forward off a ramp a lot quicker. That was a really solid run right there.
And this game definitely doesn't try to take itself too seriously. I mean, most of the skill games are based on flinging your rider or otherwise putting him in horrific situations.
Oh yeah.
And you're actually not gonna end up seeing it, but after a lot of the levels, there are sequences where your rider gets nukes dropped on him or he gets catapulted into lakes or.
Yeah. There's a lot of explosions in this game.
But there's the first fight of the run.
Yeah.
Which is unfortunate. We only lost about 10 seconds.
And this track, he actually has a zero fault it, so. And this track, again, has a lot of physics things, non-static parts moving that affect the driveline, which are most of the time pretty fun. Yeah, that run was really smooth. This is the end right here.
Thank you for the $101 donation, Kurt Mate. Get in! Good luck on the run and the ninja, you sexy beasts.
You just don't like to tell the get-in story.
Yeah, if you want to.
So with that get-in thing right there, basically, whenever Blaze is streaming and riding and kind of became a joke on Raid Call with a group of Trials players, whenever he gets a personal best or a world record, he always screams get in really loud. And it kind of catches everyone off guard if you're not paying attention to a stream. So that's kind of his trademark saying.
It's something that's kind of been like a virus or a plague around the Trials players and the Trials streams in general. Everybody starts to do it. So it's quite funny.
Thank you for the $5 donation, Heplooner. Trials hype? Put this money towards whatever Zimbabwe wants.
Ooh, nice.
Oh, yeah. You have to figure that out. Thank you for the $10 donation, Michael Cena. Tony Hawk 2 bonus game? Heck yes!
Okay, so here we have the FMX, which is brand new to Fusion. This is a trick system that's in the game. There are many different tricks that you can do. And a few of them are going to be displayed here on the two screens to the right and the left of me.
Yeah, some of the tricks are pretty funky when you do them.
And to put it nicely, the FMX system in this game is a little wonky.
It's pretty difficult. So each like position your bike can be in is like vertical, upside down, like horizontal, like, or horizontal, and then upside down vertical. There's four directions, so there's total like 16 regular tricks, and doing some of these can be a little bit awkward.
It is a very funny system in the Trials games, because when you do FMX in single player tracks, just before a landing, sometimes your rider can get stuck in the bike in all sorts of positions, and it's quite funny to see.
Yeah, also the rider is definitely controlled by the physics engine. I mean, there are times in this game where if you hit the ground hard enough, your rider will place his bottom inside of the engine block.
I've never seen that before.
Oh, yeah.
Ripped it apart. So now he's gonna have to start doing single player FMX tracks after he's doing the, he's going back to do the tracks he skipped in the beginning because he's unlocked the Roach, which is the fastest for this. And that's what I was talking about, the coasty tracks. This track is a lot of not holding gas, surprisingly, because you're going down steep hills, so. You'll see that showed off in this track a bit. And this is the very first track of the game, too, that he skipped. So that's like a subtlety that some people might not realize when they're playing this game for the first time. Like, he slowed down on that ramp, because you can go fast and launch extremely high into the air when you come back down, you're still gonna have a lot of speed, but stopping and getting over that ramp, like right here he's doing right now, is a lot faster than launching up into the air and having a lot of hang time and floating.
Okay, so here we're gonna go back to Dirt Derby, and this track it's the first track that we're going to use the TKO Panda on, which is a brand new bike to Trials Fusion. This has four-wheel drive, and it operates a little bit differently to most other bikes in the Trials franchise. It's a quad.
Yeah, so odd enough about this bike is actually the front wheels have more power than the back, which is obviously the exact opposite for the rest of the bikes. And you'll see him leaning forward quite a bit to get his weight over the front. On certain parts in the later on in the Panda track, so physics is like all this game is really is just learning all the physics. So yeah, he's gonna have to restart on that one, but And this bike is a lot heavier than the other bikes. Like, it falls faster, it's harder to move, it's the least agile, but if you hit things smooth, it goes really quick.
Spoiler alert, he's number one.
The wind turbines provide 98% of all electricity for the city.
We have a $5 donation from Zerputter. Hey, Zerputter here. Get yourself some spaghetti, Blaze, and rock this run. P.S. Get in there.
So this next whole section is going to be all panda tracks after he does Cliffhanger, which is going to be a little bit changed up a bit. And then after that, he's not going to be using the panda at all anymore, so you have to utilize most of the bikes in this run, which is a pretty cool aspect.
This here is the last track that you have to zero fault, the 100% run. Hopefully this will go swingly.
Thank you for the $100 donation, Nikiev Azeroth. I first got addicted to Trials after watching AKA Mike B trying to drunkenly donkey everything. Whilst this was a different type of run, it's still just as entertaining. But more importantly, $100 for the announcer with the dulcet tones. If you're a streamer, I'd love to grab a point of your channel. Either way, put this towards announcer's choice, which will be the Metroid Fusion 1% race, is my current choice. Very hyped. It's got a ways to go, though.
So this is the first FMX track he has to do in single player, and he's basically doing tricks, and as you see, it starts off yellow when he does a trick, and holding it to orange increases your multiplier, so yeah, there's lots of screaming in FMX, but getting his multiplier up is going to give him the most points. Shout out to Vantier for doing an amazing tutorial on this, because this is surprisingly difficult. Like, it looks pretty easy in comparison to most tracks, because it's just going up and down jumps, not too many obstacles, but balancing it in the air is pretty hard. Getting your rider to actually do what joystick button you pressed. So this is another skill game called Crank, where he's gonna have to get to exactly 200 meters to get gold again, and you're gonna see him bail out right when he gets there, but he has an energy bar on the side, and basically going fast and keeping your momentum going, doing tricks raises your energy bar, basically keeping your speed up is the main thing he's gonna be doing right now. You're gonna see it go down when he's going slow, but then when he starts getting speed again, it goes up pretty quickly, so. And that's all there is really to this skill game.
So there I bailed out at 200 meters. On most of the skill games, you only have to get to about 200 to get the gold medal. So as soon as we get to that, we bail out. Navigation failure. Okay, so these are the panda tracks. And as I was saying before, this entire section is all panda. So we have four tracks here coming up. And I actually very much like this bike. It's a brand new addition to Trials. I think that it's just, you know, something that's brand new to the game. It may take people that have played Trials before some time to get used to. But it's definitely worth giving time to this bike, because it is by far, in my opinion, a very good addition to the Trials franchise.
Thank you for the $200 donation from Yo. SGDQ is one of my all-time favorite things. The perfect combination of nerds contributing to an amazing cause and people pursuing their passions to excellence. Much love, Yo Shizuki. Thank you very much for the donation.
Sandstorm probability is high. You see a cloud in the distance that is not your average green. Seek shelter immediately.
Got a little slow-mo there. This is Blaze's one of the track that he's pretty amazing at. I've watched him stream this track and he's unbelievably consistent and solid at it. It's like that jump right there. A lot of subtleties you're not like you're not gonna know unless you're an active Trials player, like slowing down before that jump and then not over clearing it, because if you overshoot jumps on the quad, you can slam your body hard into it and it's gonna make you stop really quickly. Yeah, that was a pretty quick time. That was a good run.
Yeah, this is the quad DLC for Donkey Kong Country.
Sydney, the commentator. Yeah, that's another feature they added to the game, is having almost like a storyline to it, which if you actually listen to it, it's pretty interesting, but I generally play with game sounds off. I think most Trials players do.
Thank you for the $10 donation, Michigan. Couldn't be more hype for the Tony Hawk's Pro Skater speedruns. Good luck to all the runners. Here's to everyone getting a new personal best.
There is a pretty big time saver in the track. If you get that smooth and perfectly, he'll you ride right down that and then completely launch over this next part, but you have to play the track a lot to consistently hit it in any way, so. So doing FMX right there actually keeps his rider from launching backwards. If you don't do any tricks, you're gonna shoot backwards and have a longer distance to travel.
Thank you for the $5 donation, Blizzik. I haven't played Trials, but this is extremely impressive. Put this money towards whatever Zimbabwe wants, as long as he promises to do a Chamber 8 ABH in his portal race.
I'll give it a shot, but no promises.
There you go, Blizzik. He's gonna give it a try. If it's a good time, it might be a... It's been 30 minutes. If we get another roll call so everyone knows who everyone is on this fantastic camera, that would be a fantastic idea.
Yeah, I am the Boss Hoss. I'm an avid Trials player and stream occasionally with Trials, so. Blaze, roll call.
Oh, there you go. Sorry. sorry about that, guys.
You're fine.
I am the TheBlazeJP. I speedrun every single Trials apart from Trials 2 and the original Trials, which is on Miniclip. Trials Frontier is the mobile one, and as far as I know, it can't be speedrun. I'm sure we could figure out a way. I also speedrun Halo 3.
I'm Zimbabwe, I speedrun Portal.
All right, and I am Professor Broman for all of you who are wondering in chat.
So as he progresses in the game, each section is going to have an FMX except the extreme tracks. And they actually get more difficult as well, just riding them. Yeah! He's gonna go slow right here because you actually normally launch farther, but it saves him like 10 seconds on the actual run.
Okay. Sometimes the FMX can feel a little bit buggy. Depending on which one you're doing, it can sometimes release when you're holding the direction, but the system, like we've already covered, can be a little bit flimsy, but it's a very cool addition to Trials.
And this is a skill game involving only FMX, so I'm just gonna tell him what trick to do and then he has to do it. I personally think this is probably the hardest skill game in the game, just because I'm terrible at FMX, but... What? Yeah. I think this might have been the last thing I platinumed, yeah. It's pretty difficult. So we have to reach 6,000 points on this track.
Game, please. Game, please.
Oh, he got it. That was a close one. So yeah, he reached 6,000, he's gonna crash now. Never heard that sound before.
Thank you for the $100 donation, Vignac. Thanks for everything. You're so awesome each year. Can we have some clap clap for the French restream? Thank you very much for your donation, and that is a fantastic reminder that we do indeed have a French language restream, although the exact website where it is being streamed on is not available to me. I'm sure that one of our fantastic mods in chat will be able to post it very shortly.
So this is the last training program he has to do, which is going to unlock the, what is this bike called? The, not Roach. No, Phoenix is Evolution.
Oh crap. What is
this? Pit Viper. Sorry, this is still a fresh game used to Evolution, so.
This game has actually only been out for a little bit over 2 months now. So it's still fairly new.
Yeah, this bike has the quickest acceleration, can do the coolest stuff. Is the funnest bike in my opinion. You can do a lot of crazy things with it. And this is what he's gonna be playing with the rest of the hard tracks, and the extreme is gonna be used on this bike. So that explosive right there, that little red box you saw, you can actually hit it if you nick the top of it and it will launch you forward. It's not faster because it pushes you into the wall, but it doesn't really kill you, which is a little bit odd, which is the exact opposite of most explosions in this game, which make you just die really bad.
Quick reminder that there is, in fact, a wonderful prize during this game. Any donation of $10 or more will be entered into winning a Trials Fusion game, a new Trials Fusion game for the Xbox One. Quick reminder on how all of the prizes work in the marathon. If you donate during the block of the games, you don't have to specify, I'm donating for X prize. However, if you are donating cumulatively through the marathon, all donations are counted towards the grand prize. So if you donate a cumulative amount equal to what is necessary for the grand prize, you are entered.
So the start of the track he got a pretty solid time saver that's fairly difficult to hit all the time. He did it really well, but got a pretty good time on this track. He's doing really well in this run. What are we only at? Two faults? One fault?
Well, if we include the training program.
We're not including the training program.
Maybe two or three.
Yeah. I don't think anyone's ever zero faulted the whole game. That'd be unbelievably impressive, but.
Did we hit the icebreaker?
Just do it. So this is actually a challenge in the game, which is three of each track, which I mentioned earlier. But there's penguins in the game and squirrels in the game. And this one in particular is going to put random penguins throughout the track. And he's not allowed to hit them. So he has to avoid things on the drive line, which makes it pretty fun.
This is this game's equivalent of Save the Animals.
Oh, almost. Oh.
Oh.
Yeah. You touch the penguin, you die.
Thank you for the $5 donation, MDMA Crayons. Love all these runs and races, especially the Octodad and Nitronic Rush races. Can't wait to see 5-5 run Mario Kart 64. I agree, that is going to be a very hype run.
So what he did with there was actually pretty difficult, is getting that challenge and still getting the gold medal, because you can fault quite a bit by touching those cute little penguins, so.
Yeah, that is probably one of the funniest challenges in the game. The icebreaker challenge.
Yeah, there's some that flip your screen upside down and you're riding upside down, or make the screen go crazy and collecting certain things and doing tricks in a track. There's a lot of cool challenges that add playability to this game.
Another challenge that you will see later on in the run is I'm going to make the rider invisible on one of the extreme difficulty tracks.
Thank you for the $50 donation, HBAR Rules. As someone who has put hundreds of hours into the last two Trials games, your mastery of the FMX system is essentially wizardry. So congratulations.
Signs of altitude sickness include nausea, vomiting, and rigor mortis.
Especially relevant since we are in Denver.
There's also a challenge in this track where if you roll backwards just like the other one, a penguin also pops out and you have to chase it down, so you have to go really quick on it, but... Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh
yeah.
There we go.
For anyone who's wondering, all donation incentives for Trials Fusion at this point have been met, including the Icebreaker Invisible Rider Challenge and the Inferno Phone Ninja Challenge. So thank you all for that. We were lagging behind on those. So they have all been met. The current donation incentives that are coming up are the character choice for Nights into Dreams, which animal friend to use in Legend of Zelda Oracle of Seasons, and a 100% run for GoldenEye.
Yeah, this is just more FMX, doing lots of tricks, throwing your body around on the bike. It's surprisingly difficult. He's doing really, really well at it right now. This stuff right here can really mess up a good speed run.
Upon a quick investigation, I realized that all of the donation incentives I just mentioned have also already been met. So the next donation incentive that we have that is yet to be met is a glitch run of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, which is currently at $381 out of $2,500. So if you're looking to donate for something to get it to its threshold, that is the first one to go for that is coming up chronologically.
So this skill game is called Ice Climb. Basically, you go up the track and it gets progressively more difficult, and you climb higher and higher. There is actually an end to it, but only one person has ever got to the end. And he is an unbelievably amazing rider, so. That was only necessary to go to a certain level to get gold on that.
So here we're going back to the last set of medium tracks. Usually, in anything but the 100% run, there's loads of different categories in Trials Fusion. In anything but the 100% run, you actually have to play all these tracks on the Roach, which is actually incredibly difficult because these are quite technical medium tracks. And the Pit Viper is the bike best suited to challenge these tracks.
So yeah, this is a futuristic swamp, I guess. Everything's futuristic in this game. So when we're 70, this is what they're gonna look like. Right here, Trials of Fusion predicted it. Also on these tracks, he can like fall once on these mediums, but it's obviously faster without trying not to fall in a cleaner run, so he still has a pretty solid run going right now. Hasn't had anything stop him at all, any of the skill games mess him up or anything. Because the FMX and skill games are the things that can easily stop a good run from happening.
Thank you for the $1 donation, Polly. Happy 200,000 followers, SDA. So we just hit 200,000 followers on the SDA. Thank each and every one of you for helping us reach that. That's wonderful. We're happy that you all come and watch these marathons with us twice a year, and we thank you, of course, for all the donations. Let's keep it rolling.
Once he finishes up this last set of mediums, the run gets quite a bit more exciting. Extremes are my favorite to watch. They make these tracks look like a joke, so it's just gonna finish these up real quick and then move on to some pretty fun stuff. He's still fine on this track. It's still possible to get gold. I think you can get 2 or 3 faults on this track to get gold.
The hard tracks are much more lenient with golds. You do not have to 0 fault these to get the gold.
And this is the second to last FMX track, so he's almost done with the pretty difficult stuff. This one is temple themed, as you can see. Looks pretty cool, but this one has a lot of high soaring jumps, and you float for quite a while on some of these, so it's not the best thing for a speedrun, but to get tricks in and get the most points, you need that air time.
I'd emulate the Yelps, but I don't want to be responsible for the death of thousands of headphones users.
You should just do it.
Thank you, George White, for your $20 donation. I saw Trials Fusion was on, and now I am suddenly inspired to donate. Put this towards killing the animals to show that humans are the dominant species on Earth.
Jeez.
Intense. Shoutouts to my homeland, New Zealand. Thank you to anyone and everyone who is watching from all over the world.
So this skill game, basically the first two events, he builds up score, and as he does this last part, the score goes down. So the faster you do the second half, the higher your score is going to be. And it's probably one of the easier skill games in the game, honestly. It's just holding gas, so not too terribly difficult. And he has one more section of hards. These ones are a little bit more technical than the previous section, and then he's going to get into the extremes, which is pretty exciting to watch.
Thank you for the $15 donation, deemed most inappropriate. Hey guys, first time watcher here. Shout outs to Doctors Without Borders and the work they do. Keep it up, everyone.
He's a vegetarian. Keep going.
The commentary in this game is just absolutely fantastic.
Oh, it's incredible.
Thank you for the $10 donation, TimBike12, Tony Hawk and Portal speedruns. Awesome.
You'll find out.
This right here is probably one of the trickiest hard tracks in Fusion. There is a lot of bombs. A lot of bombs. And there's a lot of lifts with more bombs on.
Yeah, there's a lot of explosives. This track can be pretty tricky. There's physics objects, explosives, a lot of things that can kill you in this track, but
I was very relieved when I finally got the platinum on this one.
That was a pretty big time saver he just hit there, just like within the track itself. And then that bomb right there that drops down control you really bad and make you explode all the time.
A quick reminder of who we are and what we are doing this for. We are Speed Demos Archive and Speedruns Live. We are currently raising money for Doctors Without Borders. Doctors Without Borders is an international humanitarian organization created by doctors and journalists in France in 1971. Today, they provide independent and partial assistance to individuals in more than 60 countries whose survival is threatened by violence, neglect, or catastrophe due to armed conflict, epidemics, malnutrition, exclusion from healthcare, or natural disasters. In 1999, Doctors Without Borders received the Nobel Peace Prize for their efforts. And we are Speed Demos Archive, the premier community for video game speedruns, which is completing games as quickly as possible through extensive planning, practice, and knowledge of game mechanics and glitches, and Speedruns Live, the best place to race video games online against others. Players of all skill levels are welcome to join. Whether you'd like to become competitive or just race casually with friends, you can go to their front page at speedrunslive.com.
This track is the longest track in the game. It's pretty technical too. I would say it's harder than the first extreme track, but it's a good time would be sub 30 in a live run. It'd be an excellent time, but this track goes for quite a while. Sydney. but that was a pretty good time saver hit right there. Pretty difficult to get that back wheel bounce off that part. Besides those faults, this is a really clean run. So I'm pretty sure this is the last hard track he has to play besides the hard skill game and the hard FMX. And then it's gonna go into the extremes, which there's no skill, or there is a skill game, there's no FMX in the extreme section, so he's getting almost done with the swinging his biker around. Did I answer? Oh, yeah. And this is the last FMX.
This FMX track is probably the hardest in the game. I have been known to slip up on this one, but let's see what happens.
Yeah, that rider loves to scream. Surprising, I've never seen a fault in that invisible pixel, and then getting gold as well, that was nice.
it'd be really interesting to know how I faulted the but this one right here, most people use the pit viper run. You can only use your back tire. You see there's a bar on the left side.
He has to get to 200 meters again as well. This is by far one of the more difficult skill games. Yeah, that one can be pretty tricky, getting it. So this is the last hard track, and this unlocks extremes, and also unlocks the last bike called the Rabbit, which is like a BMX bike, but it's super lightweight and super slow. It's basically for fun, and there's some ninja tracks with some pretty crazy wall climbs that you can go, because it has unbelievable traction.
Thank you for the $10 donation, Dashable Link. Well, it's morning in Europe, it must be pretty darn late for you guys, yet you keep working to maintain the charity, and that deserves some serious applause. Keep it up. Thank you for the $30 donation, Neckport. Been watching all of the stream and loving it. Can we get a wave going? I will donate again if we can. We send it back.
Send it back. Oh, okay.
All right, there you go, net point. I will be watching for your next donation. Thank you, Dale13, for your $5 donation. Great stuff you're doing here, all these games you're playing, and you are keeping me hooked.
Babby's first bike.
So yeah, now he's going to extremes. We gotta get some owl hype going. Shout out to Matt for this mask.
That mask. Thank you for the $300 donation. From Gassy Mexican, sitting on the couch with Lol Renene, enjoying the stream immensely. Looks like it'd be a blast to be there. Always happy to donate to a very worthy cause. Clappas all around. Clappas indeed. Thank you very much for the donation.
Let's get some hype for the Zero Fault Extreme right there.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
Yeah, so as you can see, these are quite a bit more difficult than the previous tracks.
I'm having trouble reading donations because of the mask. That was incredible.
So in Charles Evolution, which was the previous game before this, there was a track called Dark City Run, and then this one's called Light City Run, and it's pretty difficult.
Dude, your voice with that on, it's so good.
The owl mask is making it very hard for anyone to do anything in this room. Thank you for the $20 donation from Nero. Blaze, you make it look so easy, it's ridiculous. By the way, did anyone notice how this game resembles Portal with the announcer being GLaDOS and the world made from platforms? Uh-huh. Professor, you decide where the money goes. Conspiracy!
Nice.
Dan Smith 11 for your $10 donation. Hello SDA, love everything you're doing for Doctors Without Borders and the amount of fun you bring to people around the world with your speedruns and the money you raise. Put this towards either killing the animals or saving them, reader's choice. I will kill the animals. Yeah, because that's fast.
Well, folks, that's another for the highlight reel.
Is that all the jams?
Man, that was.
Okay.
this is Inferno 4. This is much harder than all the other streams. It's really hot in there. it's pretty difficult. And then the ninja that's gonna be run is this track, but three difficulty levels above that, if that's believable.
I'm gonna throw $20 to runner's choice.
$20 to runner's choice.
Okay.
Okay. $40 coming from the people behind for runner's choice, whatever that might be. $40, because I can count.
$40.
That checkpoint's probably my least favorite one. It's can ruin a lot of good runs.
I tried to go back down there. Made the fault.
So we're gonna get ready for time. When he hits level 8, that's when you can stop it. He'll bail out real quick.
So this is the last skill game in this run. This skill game has like randomly generated cubes and rectangles. Every time you play this, they have different orientations. And time.
Time.
With the two challenges, that was really solid.
Yeah. That's good.
102.40.
I believe you do owe us some invisible.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, all of the incentives have been met, so.
Right, let's do it. It
must be done. While we're setting up for that, I got a $20 donation from Max Montezuma, who simply says owl hype.
Who?
He says owl hype.
Owl hype? He's,
yes, hype, yes. Fantastic.
It's too hot in there. So a lot of the challenges, it's just rolling backwards. There's other methods of initiating them, but this is makes your rider invisible, so it's pretty awkward to watch. For some reason, it awkwardly like changes the physics of the game. I mean, the weight's not there, but I feel like they put a dummy object. It's a lot more difficult with this.
Got it.
There we go. Oh, nice. That one's difficult.
And then we have the Invisible Rider Challenge.
Doing Inferno 4 Ninja.
Inferno 4 Ninja, yes.
That's gonna be ran by me. A lot of money. That's gonna make it real difficult.
Also, many of you are asking in chat about the who is running this game and where can you follow this person. It is on the. Oh, well, now it is not on the stream anymore, as we change the layout, but hopefully it'll come back and or one of our fantastic mods can guide you the right direction. We have a $10 donation from Origami Zergling. This is for the amazing recovery. You know which one it was. Runner's Choice. I think we all know which amazing recovery that was for sure.
This game doesn't like to type for some reason. Wait, is this keyboard plugged in?
Potentially not.
Thank you for the $35 donation. Oh, the pacifist.
I guess
pop
it is.
Tart. This is for the amazing owl mask.
How else are we gonna search for this real quick? We'll just search extremes and find it. Oh, it's not going to be on here because it has a...
Thank you for the $15 donation, Krusty Mustard. Thanks so much for what you're doing. This is a great event for a great cause.
Can we get the keyboard plugged in?
No, we got it. Here we go. The search would help, I guess.
Thank you for the $5 donation, Insane SVK. Shoutouts to you guys. Speedrunning is really difficult, and you make it look like a piece of cake. And it's all for a great cause.
I'm turning subtitles off, sorry. It's distracting. So this is actually the ninja difficulty, which after extreme, there goes ninja level 1, 2, and 3. And this takes quite a while. It's extremely difficult. And this is considered level 3, so like 3 levels higher than a regular extreme track, so.
Basically what Red Links have done here is they have taken Inferno 4 and they've made it like 3 times harder.
Talk about how getting to it.
There would be much hype if we can get a run under 10 minutes here. This would be something.
Yeah, it's a lot more precise and it's just difficult. I'm not really gonna worry about faults, just more about time on this one.
We have a $10 donation from Beatnik AU.
What he's trying to do here is he's trying to grip with his back tire very, very closely to the edge of the wheel, try and get traction to come up it. He's doing this by leaning forward and letting go of lean forward.
So this is probably my second least favorite obstacle in this track. It's bouncing off a spinning cylindrical object and going onto another one is not easy, but we'll get it.
What he's trying to do here is he's trying to get the top wheel, which is rotating clockwise, to grab his front tire and brake on it and pull his momentum around.
Almost. There we go.
Yeah.
That's what's gonna happen.
Mm-hmm.
That one's a little bit more harder to fender hook than another object, but...
So I'll explain the fender hook. A fender hook is when you are basically falling backwards on your bike and you clip the edge of a piece of geometry. Now what this does is, if you're holding gas, your bike's back tire gets stuck in between the tire and the fender of the bike, which can swing you back around to a normal position.
Oh my gosh, I'm losing grip on this really bad. Little barrels are always fun. You just gotta get your back tire on that last barrel and get a good pop off of it, and then avoid getting, get on the next barrels and then avoid the explosives. So this is a fun one.
I don't know if fun is the word I'd use here.
I find ninjas enjoyable. It's just always aggravating challenge.
Oh yeah.
This is probably my least favorite checkpoint of this track.
So right here, we probably have one of the most trickiest checkpoints in this ninja. What he has to do here is endo on the barrel and then quickly switch to the back and then bunny hop over.
That can happen a lot, just getting up there. You have to hit this pretty precisely. That's a lot quicker than normal, which is nice.
Again, a similar technique here to pop up on your front tire endo. And
this one is a back wheel bounce to a vertical wall to, you have to get your nose over the next piece, so this checkpoint is pretty difficult as well. All of them are, but. Oh, nope. On PC, 9. On Xbox across, I'm sure there's probably maybe a couple hundred. There we go.
Yeah.
Yeah, this checkpoint is pretty fun. It's a lot of wall.
Just because I'm not sure everyone heard this, how many people have finished this on PC?
On PC, there's 9 on the leaderboards currently.
9. Total effort.
Yeah, out of a lot. But on Xbox and other ones, there's a lot of other Ninja Riders that have beaten it, so.
Trials Fusion is across 4 platforms.
Yeah.
Xbox 360, Xbox One, PC, and PlayStation 4.
Oh. I'd also like to take this time to point out that trials riding is an actual sport that is very interesting to watch. You should check it out on YouTube.
Absolutely.
However, don't be disappointed because, spoiler alert, they can't go up 50-foot walls.
I lost grip a little bit there. We'll get this in a second. Oh yeah, they definitely do that. Oh. No, I don't like going backwards. That was about as close as you can get with not getting it, so kind of disappointing. This checkpoint normally does not give me this much trouble. Well, you did it on your Nitronic Rush game, didn't you? There we go.
Oh!
That went surprisingly well. This is more vertical wall fun, but... Oh, that was close. This is all just throttle control, slowly letting off of it at the right times, but... Anyone can beat this if you just practice a lot of hours, so go for it.
Trails is a game that does have a steep learning curve, but it's just a matter of practice, and eventually anybody can get this game.
To be fair, so is brain surgery.
Oh, just lost grip a little bit. This is frustrating. I'll get it in a second. There we go.
Yeah.
This is the last checkpoint for some reason. I have 20 seconds to get it in 10 minutes. Let's see if we can do it. That guy really wants to be a friend. Shouldn't have stayed online. Oh, that was it. There we go.
Yeah!
That track has yet to be zero faulted, but it'll probably happen one day. There's some pretty amazing ninja riders out there, so. Someone 14 faulted that on PC.
Wow.
Steve, he's wow. He's 14. An amazing ninja rider. It's yeah, live might be a little different, but.
It's fantastic. Well, thank you both to It's Blaze JP.
Yeah.
And Boss Hoss for the fantastic trials demonstration.
Can I just say a big shout out to everybody that's doing it for trials. You guys are awesome.
Yes, it was incredible. I'm gonna try and power through some donations here while we have Boss Hoss and It's Blaze JP around so they can hear it. Thank you, Jacob. Sick Trials Fusion Run. This game looks like tons of fun. Thank you so much for putting this together. It's a great celebration of gaming, and it's all for a good cause. Thank you, Matt Ressler. Woke up, saw one dude doing sick motorcycle tricks on the side of a mountain and another dude chilling in an owl mask, and no one was panicked. Don't know what's going on, but I figured I better get some money in on it. All right, so thank you all for joining us for Trials Fusion. Up next, we have SSX3 run by Cloak Dioshi. It's going to be fantastic. We will be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Thank you for sticking with us. A quick reminder of who we are and what we are doing. This is Summer Games Done Quick,